A flooded bathroom.
I've got an ancient moving coil speaker from 1928. I thought I'd get it going and find out what sort of hi-fi I could get back in that time. Now, a brief history. This is a prototype built in 1921 of the first electrodynamic speaker, built by Chester W. Rice and Kellogg of GE. What was really holding back the audio industry was the need for a decent loudspeaker. If you've seen my previous video on ancient speakers, you can see they really were the weak link in the chain. The microphones and electrical circuits weren't that bad. The cabinet had an inbuilt amplifier that gave about a watt. This was the first time you could get really decent sound from a loudspeaker. Development continued until around 1924 or 25, when they were released commercially. This was the same time that electrical recordings was introduced. And for the first time, you could monitor in good quality what was going down on the wax. Now, I had to do a little bit of work on the voice coil. It had corroded where the wires went into the former. When I'd finished, it sounded like this. Sorry about the wobbly shots. I never intended to use this in a published video. You can see I'm using a pile of batteries to energize the massive field coil.
I'm holding on to. Although during it, both Marie and I said our last goodbyes.
I've put it in an appropriate 1920s box, just like a recording studio would have used in 1928. Now to pick some music that was recorded in the same year the loudspeaker was manufactured. Of course, it does sound a bit better on more modern speakers. Yes, I know there's a few funny resonances and things, but considering most people at this time were still listening on tinny horn speakers or maybe cone speakers, but if you're able to afford one of these, You had quite good fi back in 1928. If you go to Mr. Prozoot's excellent site, you can hear early electrical 78s in almost hi-fi quality. These are pristine records never played by the damaging pickups of the day. I'm sure the engineers of the time, when recording this, had no idea of the detail they were putting into the grooves.